Hi everyone, today's evening headlines. Alappuzha twin murder, SDPI is a terrorist organization. Omicron, center deploys multidisciplinary teams in these 10 states to contain COVID-19 threat level. Omicron cases in India, 415 infections of new coronavirus variant recorded in 17 states or UTs so far. Lundhiana blast accused had links with Khalistani elements, terror outfits. Uma Bharti's false alarm forces trained to halt for 2 hours in UP's Lalitpur. News in details. Alappuzha twin murder, SDPI is a terrorist organization. Muralidharan on Saturday said that the Kerala government is utilizing the Alappuzha twin murder issue to denigrate RSS. He gave this statement hours after Kerala DGP Anil Kant ordered police officials to prepare a district-wise list of those previously involved in criminal cases, including members of the RSS and the SDIP and the SDPI. DGP Kant issued these guidelines in the backdrop of 2 killings of political members of the BJP and the SDPI in the Alappuzha district. Calling SDPI a terrorist organization, the MES said that the two cannot be equated. Criminal list should be impartial without considering the party a person belongs to. In Kerala, the largest number of criminals will be from CPIM anyway. Cases of thousands of CPIM workers were withdrawn when this government came to power, Muralidharan told ANI. Omicron, center deploys multidisciplinary teams in these 10 states to contain COVID-19 threat level. The rapid increase in Omicron cases in the country has put the country on high alert, forcing the central government to deploy additional surveillance team in 10 states with high caseload as a potential third wave of the COVID-19 pandemic looms. A decision has been taken to deploy multidisciplinary central teams to 10 identified states, some of which are either reporting an increasing number of Omicron and COVID-19 cases or slow vaccination pace, the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare said in an official statement. The multidisciplinary central teams will be deployed in Kerala, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, Mizoram, Karnataka, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, and Punjab. Omicron cases in India, 415 infections of new COVID variant recorded in 17 states or UTs so far, informs Center. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare on Saturday informed that a total of 415 cases of the new Omicron variant of coronavirus have been detected in 17 states or UTs of India so far. The Health Ministry has further informed that as many as 115 persons have recovered after getting the Omicron infection, with 108 cases. Maharashtra remains the worst affected by the new COVID-19 strain in the country, followed by Delhi 79, Gujarat 43, and Telangana 38. The other states or UTs that have reported the Omicron cases are Kerala 37, Tamil Nadu 34, Karnataka 31, Rajasthan 22, Haryana 4, Odisha 4, Andhra Pradesh 4, Jammu and Kashmir 3, West Bengal 3, Uttar Pradesh 2, Chandigarh 1, Ladakh 1, and Uttarakhand 1. Meanwhile, the country has reported 7,189 fresh cases of COVID-19 and 387 virus-related deaths in the last 24 hours, as per the MOHFWS latest update. With this, India's COVID-19 tally has risen to 3,47,79,815, while the fatality count has reached 4,79,520. Lundhiana blast accused had links with Khalistani elements, terror outfits. Punjab DGP Siddharth on Saturday said that the man who was killed in the Lundhiana blast case and was also behind the explosion had links with Khalistani elements, terror outfits across the border, mafia outfits and narcotics smugglers. On Friday, one person was killed and 6 others injured in a bomb blast in the Lundhiana District Court complex, prompting the Punjab government to declare a high alert in the state. The deceased has been identified as former policeman Gagandeep Singh. Singh, a former head constable of Punjab Police, was arrested by STF in a drug trafficking case in 2019 and was lodged in jail since then. Siddharth said that Singh, who was suspended from the service 2 years back, had carried the explosive material to the Lundhiana District Court. the deceased person, former policeman Gagandeep Singh, was carrying the explosion. He was dismissed from service in 2019 and spent 2 years in jail following his arrest in a drug trafficking case. The Punjab Director General of Police said during a press briefing. Uma Bharti's false alarm forces train to halt for 2 hours in UP's Lalitpur. A Delhi-bound train from Tikamgarh, Madhya Pradesh was forced to halt midway after senior BJP leader Uma Bharti raised a bomb alarm. The train was thoroughly inspected by authorities in Lalitpur, Uttar Pradesh before it was allowed to resume its journey. According to reports, Umar Bharti was travelling in the HA1 compartment of the train from Tikamgarh to New Delhi on Thursday night. When the train reached the outskirts of Lalitpur, she suspected a bomb inside the train and raised an alarm. The train reached Lalitpur railway station at 9:40 p.m. and was halted till 11:30 p.m. During this period, a joint team of RPF and GRP searched the train thoroughly but could not find any kind of suspicious article. Following a 2-hour halt in Lalitpur, the train was allowed to resume further. However, the process of checking the train premises once again repeated in Jhansi. That's all for now. To get this latest news, don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you.